Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I would like to talk about how I control my skin condition, which is eczema. I think I've mentioned in the past videos that I have a skin condition and it is eczema. I figured it would be helpful to some of my viewers who also have the same skin condition. Just a little bit of background about eczema. Eczema is a skin condition. It is also known as atopic dermatitis, and it is a skin condition that makes your skin red and itchy. It is common in children, but it can also occur at any age. Atopic dermatitis is long-lasting or chronic and tends to flare periodically. In my case, I've only experienced one flare. That was the time when I was diagnosed with eczema. I was able to manage my eczema, so I never experienced any flare-up anymore. But I do experience some red patches on my skin, but it's not that severe. I was diagnosed with eczema when I was 14 years old, and that was the first flare-up. So symptoms of eczema are having dry skin, having red itchy patches or brownish-gray patches on the neck, on the upper extremities of the body, on your chest, on your head. Unfortunately, there is no cure for eczema. That's why for today's video, I will talk about how I manage my eczema and how I control it from flaring up again. So let's do it from top to bottom for my scalp or for my head area. The first time it flared up, what I used was apple cider vinegar. But now that I don't have any flare up on my head, I just maintain using Head and Shoulders, and I've been using this for 13 years now, because if I don't use this, then I get eczema. Other shampoos dry up my scalp, so that's not really nice. For conditioner, there's nothing specific I use. I can use any conditioner. For my face, this is the most maintained part of my body because I can only use fragrance-free and very mild facial wash. I can't use facial wash with strong scents. So for my face at night, I use this Clinique liquid facial soap in mild. And daytime, I use this Neutrogena Deep Clean Brightening. This has a scent, but it's not that strong. What my doctor recommended me when I had a flare-up was this Neutrogena Deep Clean Facial Cleanser. It was this kind that she wanted me to use, so I've been using it since then. It is really important to moisturize your skin when you have eczema. So for my moisturizer, I've recently discovered this Japanese product, which is the Shiro Jun, and it has done my skin well so far. It's fragrance-free, so it's very mild. This is what I use for daytime, and I mix it with the vitamin C from Claire's to whiten up my dark spots. I use the combination of these two, and also at night, I moisturize at night using this Clinique Dramatically Different Moisturizing Lotion in, I think, number 3. It's for super sensitive and dry skin. I've been using this for the past 3 years. Also, I found out this, although I haven't tried this, but this is an apple cider vinegar soap I got from Beauty Manila from the Philippines. So I haven't used this, but I think it's good for my skin because I've used apple cider in the past. And then for my body, I've been using this for 13 years now, and I don't use any other body soap except for the Dove Sensitive. So I always stock up on this. I have like 3 bars here and 3 bars there, so I have like 6 bars. So it's cheaper to get them from the Philippines, so whenever I go home, I hoard and then I bring them here to Japan. This has no fragrance at all. For my liquid body wash, I use the body wash version for this one. So I can't really use other soaps except for this one. And for my lotion, of course, winter time, it really makes your skin dry. I don't have it right now because I just finished a bottle of it, but for winter time, I use the Aveeno Eczema Therapy for Baby. But now, I just use this Aveeno Active Natural Daily Moisturizing Lotion. That's how I manage my eczema from head to foot. But sometimes, as I mentioned, I experience some red patches. I actually have eczema now here, an eczema patch. Right now, I have makeup on, so you can't really see it, but I took a video a while ago without makeup so you can see. As you can see, there is a red patch here on my nose and on this side of the nose, but the right side is much more bigger. and drier. I have eczema right now, but again, it's not a flare-up. In my last video, I used the Nivea Micelle Air, so that might have contributed to this patch, but I don't know. Maybe. So when I have a red patch like this, when I was in the Philippines, my doctor recommended me to use this cream, the Desowen cream. And it's a corticosteroid 0.05%. It's a cream and I use this and it's super effective. But here in Japan, I went to my dermatologist a couple of times and he gave me this cream, the Rocoid cream. And also the Boala. So they're both effective. I just have this inside my bag, inside my makeup kit, just in case, you know, something like this comes up. For makeup, I don't really use a particular makeup because when you use the right skincare, I think you can just use any makeup at all as long as you remove it at the end of the day. But for lipstick, I am careful because I have an allergic reaction with beeswax. So recently, most lipsticks have beeswax in it, so I can't use lipsticks with beeswax because it triggers my eczema around the lip area. I'm not really picky about makeup. I can use any makeup except for the lips. So that's it, you guys. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope this video gave you some information about eczema, and I hope this has helped you guys. If you have any comments regarding the skin condition, just comment them down below. If you have eczema, then I would love to hear from you guys how you maintain, how you manage to control your eczema, and if you have any problems regarding eczema, just comment them down below and I will share what I can share. I hope you like this video. Click the thumb button down below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do. The subscribe button is right here. If you click this button directly, then you'll be able to subscribe to my channel. And also, there's a bell button down below. Please click that bell button so that you get notified when I upload a new video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next vlog. Bye!